Hey everyone, so I've had a whole week of no salt intake, and I just wanted to talk about the changes I've noted on my body since I began my 90-day journey to lower my cholesterol, to lose weight, to lower my blood pressure. And so on the first week, first of all, I don't think I miss salt as much as I did before. Like every meal I ate before, I would add salt even without tasting the food. But now, because all the food I'm cooking is without salt, I just add a lot of like hot ingredients, like peppers, different habaneros, different types of peppers I enjoy. And for some reason, I don't miss the salt. I just don't. So that was surprising because I just did not think I would make it without salt. So that should encourage anybody that wants to try it. And so the main thing I did is just no refined foods. Everything I eat is whole. I try as much as possible, like if it's something. Like for example, today breakfast, like right now I'm having my breakfast, almond milk, I'm having my breakfast, and what I'm eating with my breakfast is sweet potatoes, just boiled. Bought them at the local store, boiled them. I'm gonna have some for breakfast and I'll have some for dinner. So for dinner, I'm gonna have the sweet potatoes with beans, pinto beans. Now, so the first thing I noticed is my water retention. My ring fits better, it's a little looser. My feet, my shoes, my running shoes fit better because I think I've had some water loss from this. And the next thing I noticed is my blood pressure, which I take every day. My blood pressure cuff is right there. Take my blood pressure every day. There's been a slight drop in the numbers. They are not as high as they were. And this is consistently during the week. And I'm not saying it's only salt because I'm doing other things also. I'm also working out every day. Like, of course, I'm minding my food. So it's not only the salt, but I feel that the salt is a huge part of it because my blood pressure was elevated and the doctor stated that the salt could be a reason why, because I just do consume a lot of salt. So another thing I could not do was check my cholesterol, because that's actually the main thing I've started this journey on. The cholesterol, we have to do the 90 days, and then I'll have to go for blood work at the doctor's office. Then I'll find out if there's been any changes on my cholesterol. Which is too early. I still have 85 more days to go. So I have noticed, like I said again, I've noticed a huge change in my I've noticed a huge change after not taking salt for 1 week. I will continue with not taking the salt, and I'm hoping to introduce no sugar. Right now I'm taking sugar substitutes, and slowly but surely I'll try to take no sugar. So, what I was wanting to relay today was that the more salt you take, the more sodium you take, the more potassium your body needs. And so if you're taking more salt and less potassium, your blood pressure will increase. And that's why salt is taking salt in moderation or taking no salt at all for people that are dealing with blood pressure is very, very important. And to balance the sodium your intake, if you're still taking salt right now, to balance the sodium intake, you can like take potassium-rich foods, which are any vegetables, most fruits, and also beans. And for me, my favorite food that has a lot of potassium is bananas. So after every meal, I do eat my banana. So I hope this helped for anybody that was wanting to know the effects of salt on one's body. All right, thank you.